Hi everyone. Today I have with me a battery that I've extracted from a vacuum cleaner. Apparently it doesn't work anymore. I've tested the rest of the vacuum cleaner and found that everything else works except for the battery. So this is the inputs of the battery. Basically the charger plugs in here to a controller board where it distributes the chargers to the four batteries inside. And here are the output wires. So by right, these two wires are supposed to be live all the time. So I am expecting it to be 7.4 volts. So connecting it up to a multimeter, let's see what we get here. Unfortunately, looks like we don't have anything. In fact, it is in negative. This could mean that the battery's protection circuit has kicked in. So it's not allowing any voltage from the batteries at all in order to prevent it from being damaged. But unfortunately, when this happens, not only that it doesn't allow it to output any power, it also does not allow the battery to charge any further. So what I'm going to do is to try to revive this battery pack by bypassing the control board and trying to bump up the voltage of the batteries ever so slightly, hoping that the control board will activate and allow me to charge the batteries again. So this is what we're going to do. So carefully, I'm going to remove the string wrap outside. And here we have the control board connecting to both the charger and as well as the output to the vacuum cleaner. Let's test the voltage of the batteries directly connected to this B plus and B minus to see if there's anything. Ooh, looks like there is some voltage at 2.35, but this is way lower than what we are expecting, because it by right should be around 7.4 volts. So this doesn't look good actually. So let's dismantle the battery even more. Hopefully we can access it without damaging it. So similarly, we're getting 2.8 volts on one pair of the cells and none on the other pair. So this voltage is way too low to allow the control board to work. So let's check out which pair. So this is one pair, and here is another pair. So what I've done is have these two batteries in parallel, and they're connected to the ends of this pair of batteries, and this is where the full 7.4 volts should be coming out from, but we are not getting it. So what I'm going to do is to try to charge this using another 18650 cell. Hopefully it is enough to reactivate the control board. Hopefully it's not too late. Hopefully it's not over discharged to the point that it is unrecoverable. So here I am using neodymium magnets, which will make it easy for me to hold on to the banana clips, the crocodile clips, I mean. So one here, and the negative side. So if it does heat up considerably, then I would have to end this immediately. So at this point, that this battery is charging the top row of cells. Let's see what happens if we remove the crocodile clip from the battery that is working. It immediately the voltage goes to almost zero, which unfortunately is not a good sign at all, because this could mean that the battery is damaged beyond saving. So a bit disappointed. Right now we can decide whether to replace these two batteries and get the vacuum cleaner working, or just salvage the remaining two working cells. If anyone decides to try to salvage this pair of batteries, it'll be easier to do than trying to rebuild the battery pack, because rebuilding a battery pack requires some spot welding to get it working. Try not to use solder, because that would heat up the battery considerably and it might be dangerous. So it requires far more equipment to rebuild the battery pack, and I'm not sure if it's worth it to proceed on to rebuild. I have decided not to repair this battery pack. Instead, what I'll do is I'll salvage the working pair and discard the other pair. So to do this, we will need to snip off the nickel tabs very carefully. While doing so, take note not to contact with any other parts of the battery or other tabs. And this is how a typical battery control board or battery management board looks like. So it usually has it has 2 points for charging and 2 points for output, and we also see a something to measure the temperature. This is a fuse, a thermal fuse. I should have tested it too. Other than that, yep. These are the MOSFETs that turn on and off the battery to the charger, or the battery to the vacuum cleaner. Removing the tabs, I find that it is best to slowly twist it, like a bit like opening up a can. So again, while doing this, make sure you're not damaging the batteries. I'm gonna do this as cleanly as possible. So before we proceed on to tear the batteries apart, because it seems that it does create a bit of damage, let's just check what's going on. So this battery is dead. This one is dead also. This one is the one that is alive. This one is dead as well. What on earth? So only one cell out of four is actually salvageable. So it's still not too bad if I damage the insulation here. But if I damage the insulation here, then that's gonna be a problem, because the only thing separating the positive and the negative shell is just a very thin layer. So yep, hopefully I don't damage this any further. Oh gosh. Yep, one cell out of four. Oh well. So that's it. This is the only one I was able to salvage. So thank you for watching.